Today I'm going to show how to replace this old 80-gallon electric water heater with this new 80-gallon hybrid water heater by Rheem.
First thing to do is come over to the electrical panel and turn off the breaker for the water heater.
You can see this hybrid water heater is a lot taller because it has the heat pump and the compressor at the top. So my water connections are about 12 inches or so higher, and that puts them above this shutoff valve. So I'll need to remove this. Up here I have PEX, and then I have copper down here. I'll eliminate all this copper and cut the PEX. And over here, I picked up these flexible lines. I'll put a link to these in the description. It connects to the PEX with a shark bite fitting. And then down here, it connects right to the water heater. So that replaces the copper lines and the union joints in one step. Well worth it if you ask me. And it has a built-in shutoff valve. So because I'm cutting above this shutoff valve, I need to shut off the water to the whole house. And that is on this side of the basement, in this closet, right here. So now I need to drain the water in all these lines going down into the tank. And there is a drain valve down here at the bottom. Here's why I'm replacing this water heater. It just started leaking around the base. This was made in 2007, so it's 18 years old. I'm not even mad. That's a great lifespan for a water heater. Connect a garden hose to this. I don't have a floor drain anywhere in this basement, so I have the hose going all the way over here into the sump pump. Now just open up this valve with the flathead. And there, I can hear the water coming out because there's still some pressure in the tank. Except, I'm not getting any water flow. A lot of times these tanks get sediment sitting at the bottom that can clog the valve. So I'm gonna close it and open it a few times to work it through. I hear water draining up there. And success. I'm upstairs and I'm gonna open up a sink to allow air into the lines, and that should help it drain a little faster. Much better. While the old tank is draining, let's start by disconnecting the electrical lines. So we have the two hot wires here. Red connects to the white wire, and there's the ground. I'll unhook the ground first. Next, this hot, the red to the white, and the other hot, which is black to black. And that's it for the electric. Up here on the Rheem, we have a warning sticker. I'll move this here as a reminder. So before turning on the power, you need to make sure all lines are connected, have the cold supply line open, and run the faucets on hot to be sure the tank is full and all air is out. And this applies to any water heater. I have two Phillips screws holding on the cover. The green screw is for a ground wire, so I'll leave that alone for now. Slide this out, and we have two hots and another ground screw. Let's go check on the drain situation. Still about the same flow. So I have some PVC fittings here and some 3/4-inch pipe, and that's gonna go to this condensate pump here because I have no floor drain. My AC makes condensation, which ends up down here, and that water gets pumped up here and ends up in this soil pipe. If you don't have a drain, you'll need this setup because the hybrid water heaters produce condensation from right here. So I'll need to have this Rheem ProTerra unit orientated so this is facing the pump. I have a male 3/4-inch adapter and that threads right in. Then I'll have a T fitting with a cap on top for cleaning, and the pipe will go down and with a couple elbows end up right in here. So I went ahead and bought another pump just to have as a backup, same model, just because
This one's gonna be doing double duty now. I took a break and grabbed some lunch, and this is still draining. I don't wanna wait all afternoon for this to drain. It's getting pretty low. So I can go ahead and disconnect these lines, then I can get this out of the way and move the ream in place and hook it up. It's still really heavy. I got the tray all cleaned up. So the idea behind the bricks is if it does leak, it won't be sitting at a puddle of its own water. But these bricks are really scratchy, and I don't want to scratch the underside of the new tank. So I have a couple plastic tray lids here. This way, I'll be able to slide the new tank up here without scratching the paint off of the bottom. The condensation outlet is on this side, so it needs to face that way. I used a piece of wood to tilt the old tank and help it drain. So the water lines are positioned correctly. The PVC is positioned correctly to go down here, right over to the pump. And over on this side, we have the fan for the heat pump. And it needs to blow into an open area, which I have here. I don't think I want it blowing right into a wall. So it all works out. And up top here, I have my cold right under my cold. And my hot above my hot. And even if the lines weren't right above each other, remember, these new lines are flexible. So no worries there. I'll just thread these on finger tight for now. And that'll give me an idea of how I need to bend these and about where I need to cut the PEX lines. To cut the PEX, I'm using an old pipe cutter for a clean cut. If you don't have one of these, I'll put a link down in the description. Make sure these are nice and clean. No burrs or anything on the inside. And now, just press it together. And once it's in, give it a good pull to make sure it's not coming out. And same for the cold side. I feel like this one could go in a little farther. There it is. And now tighten the base. So with all the water lines connected, I can turn the water back on and check for leaks. That's the sound of the tank filling up. Let's take a look up here. Dry, 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 and dry. This comes with side inlets as well. Make sure they're not leaking. They come capped. All good there. So I'm back upstairs where I left these open, and there was probably a lot of air coming out of the hot side. And now I have a steady stream of water, so the air has been expelled from the new tank. Let's make sure on another faucet. Here's cold. And there's hot. Still a lot of air coming out from the hot side. So I'll leave this open to let all the air out of the tank, which is important to do. All right, it's been a few minutes and I have a steady stream of water with no more air from the hot side. Now I can power it on. First, let's remove this cover from the old tank and put on the cover from the new tank. I'm not going to be able to use this ground screw because my ground wire is inside the conduit. So I'll have to use this ground screw right here. All right, I used some needle nose to bend this in a hook shape, and that hook is going to slip under the head of the screw. I needed two hands to do that,
but here's how it looks. And we have the white wire with tape going to the red wire. Actually, these new wires are thicker. And I ended up breaking the old wire nut trying to twist it on. So I got these larger red wire nuts to use instead. All connected. Now I need to stuff these wires down in here so I can attach the cover. Kind of a tight fit. Now I can install the Phillips screws. And done. Now for the PVC, I'll need to install a T-fitting with a cap on top and a small pipe from here to here. Clean out all the burrs. And that's gonna go in here. So to figure out the height for my pipe, it's gonna come down to about here. And a little higher because of the two elbows. So right about there. So I need to cut it right about here. And now I need some elbows. So about 10 and a half inches. And one last piece of pipe to go down in that hole. Another little piece at the top of the T and a cap. And this will allow me to clean it out if needed. Now I need to glue this contraption together. First, I'm gonna put some primer on the end of the pipe. This isn't very purple. And the T-fitting. And next I have some PVC cement and put a little bit of that on the pipe and the fitting and smush them together. And repeat. Checklist is complete, and it's time to power this thing on. In the instruction manual, Rheem actually has a full list. There it is. An entire list of every detail of the installation. Really helpful for beginners. And it works. I need to download the app and connect it to Wi-Fi, and I'll make additional videos about the energy savings and the loudness. Seems to be a concern with these hybrids. But do me a favor and hit thumbs up if this was helpful, and thanks for watching.